USA against Kenya. The 50th meeting of these two great Sevens nations that feel like they are forever intertwined on the series. Here they come, the Shuja Pride and the United States of America. Well, the USA started with a silver in Dubai, but they just haven't been able to podium since. Defense has been a little bit of an issue for them, that's for sure. But with the likes of Kayvon Williams out there leading them, they're looking to make a strong assault on this Singapore Sevens. And how about the Kenyans? From the sublime to the frustrating at times, Nelson Oyu is captaining the Shuja Pride, one of the most popular sides on the series. Fourth playing eight. Kenya will have in the back of their mind that they humbled the USA 29 points to nil in Dubai. And Gareth Rees, we've got a tasty match on our hands.
Yes, I think this American side want to set the record straight. And the Kenyans always provide excitement.
USA
very
ready?
Proud nation. They, in fact, were the last team to beat South Africa in pool play, which is quite a remarkable thing when you think about what may be happening later today in the South Africa-Canada game.
Well, fond memories for this Kenyan nation of their time in Singapore. Champions here in 2016, destroying Fiji in the final. But that's the thing, you've got to get to that final first, and it all starts here. Game one against the USA. Mike Friday's dogs out of the kennel and looking to attack down this left flank. Lovely bit of interplay with the basketball style offload. A box of tricks from this United States of American team, and an overload already. Maybe Perry Baker pulled back at the crucial moment, but as it is,
Swan White,
a pull on the jersey. Well, one of the greats of the game. 216 tries in 52 tournaments. He hasn't won this one, though. He came close during that North American epic when they missed out to Canada. He got two tries in that final.
Crouch.
He'll want to get onto the biggest stage once again.
Sit.
But Kenny's standing their way. The ball's in Daniel Tabu's hands. And we're away. Good bit of disruption coming in from Folau Nua. A rejuvenated man, according to Mike Friday, from some of your chats this week, Gareth.
Not going to advantage.
A lot of competition in the contact areas, as you'd expect with these two sides. A good tackle in the hands of Baker. Baker roaming free. That's where we like to see him, in green pastures. But he's forced to offload and USA distribute out wide. Good composure from the United States. A glint of an opportunity, but the offload too low round the bootstraps and a knock on.
Well, Maceo Brown did well not to give that pass. As the Kenyans were looming for an intercept, they just spilled it. Just watch as he looks up. Oh, if he'd have passed it, it would have been couple all round, I think.
Oh, just too low for a speeding.
Fine.
Kayvon Williams.
Set.
He would have finished that with ease. Another scrum for Kenya. This one's a lot cleaner. No concerted time in possession. Look at that strength in the challenge. Oh, picked up and not very delicately put down.
Yep.
Play continues. Goodness me, did these two sides have a ding-dong in Tokyo in the Olympics?
Oh, the ball on the ground, off feet.
Well, two great Olympic nations, and isn't it great that Rugby Sevens is part of that conversation now? So many subplots here. We've also got the World Cup of Sevens down in South Africa in September.
Well, Danny Tabu, who's on the ball, he was out there at the Olympics, and he's trying to light the attacking fire of the Kenyans.
Holding on, extra roll.
Wow, quick on that ball, and the referee quick on the whistle for holding on.
Yeah, just holding on at the breakdown. They felt there was Americans there trying to poach the ball. And Nelson Oyu just taking too long on the ball, maybe a bit quick, but it will be a U.S. kick. chance to gain some territory and work off a line-out set piece here.
Nice bit of structure for the USA to play with now.
And you mentioned that man there, Folau Niue. He's transformed his body, super fit. And Mike Friday said you won't recognize him. He's throwing in there, he's going to get it back again.
Well, the big hulking frame takes the ball down and pretty structured stuff from the USA. They'll tap for the penalty and Niue will go. Perry Baker on the flank and Perry Baker doing what he does. Getting across that whitewash for a try.
Well, it was the 37-year-old Niue who started it, and it was the 35-year-old Perry Baker. Times World Rugby Player of the Year, Sevens Player of the Year. There's the quick tap from Niue. Simple hands, and one-on-one with Baker with 10 meters to cover. It's not a very comfortable place to be, Joe.
But it's one that Baker will gobble up all day. That is try number 217 in 52 World Series events here on the HSBC World Series. And he draws a level with Carlin Isles again. Those two enjoying their own little dogfight at the top of the USA try scoring rankings. Remember, they both hit 200 at the LA 7 simultaneously back in 2020, wasn't it? Goodness me, I remember the hype around that. That was exciting. But both on 217.
Stephen Thomasine on that list, still available for selection, just injured at the moment. Some great other names, Zach Test, Madison Hughes, who I think we may be getting to hear from in the commentary booth later on, the Dartmouth product.
The commentary comes to us all, Gareth Rees. The commentary comes to us all. Well, Kenya looking to get a bit of continuity in this game.
Of course, this is great hunting ground for them. Back in 2016, they won their title here in Singapore.
Crouch.
One of five nations to have won.
Bind. Sit.
It was extraordinary stuff. Spearheaded by Collins Injera, who isn't with us today. Goodness me, the sound of that hit coming in.
Holding.
And it's that aggressive defense that forces holding on from the USA in the contact. Here come Kenya. Goodness, five players in that tight channel. The white jerseys finally into the USA half. Tucked under the arm by Humwa. It's muscular, it's direct from the Kenyans, and they find a little glint and then an offload. The rangy running of Wekesa, the offload to Omondi.
Just be careful when you're
Kenya
careful.
On the board.
Tony Omondi gets the reward, but great backing up from the Kenyan players. Look at that, ball in two hands, then it goes into one hand. You know what's coming. Keeps that ball alive. Good linear support, backing up all the way. Look how hard they're working off the ball to make themselves available. And this is what happens when you work that hard. Tony Omondi, try.
No. No.
Oh.
The time is over. The clock
that
is
was
over.
To take the lead.
Half time.
Well, a significant say in the way that this first half has ended between the USA and Kenya. It has been tooth and nail all game, physical as you like. And that's why there is nothing between them. USA 5, Kenya 5. Well, Tony Omondi profiting from the rampaging work of Bush Mwale. Maybe looking to make a point from, because he was at the Rio Olympics, wasn't out in Tokyo. But that kind of rampaging action is the stuff that gets you to the big events. We got big events this year in sevens, haven't we, Gareth Rees?
Yes, we do. Of course, the Rugby World Cup of Sevens in Cape Town in September. Nice opportunity to listen in.
So that's the other half of the equation in Pool A, but we're looking at the first part, and that's USA and Kenya. Nothing between them after 7 minutes.
In front of the kicker.
And a sloppy mistake in front of the kicker means that Kenya will have possession, looking to drive the game with some tempo and put their big runners in the 15-meter channel. Billy Odhiambo.
Backwards.
And Kenya forced back to the halfway line.
Now there's no finish there, offside.
They come all the way back. The Americans were offside at the previous ruck. Referee Craig Chan from Hong Kong. Great to see him out here.
Well, Kenya enjoying their most fruitious period of play. They've had their hands on the ball, they've got their possession. And when the big men come a running, you can see them poised in the midfield. A run on the inside acts as a decoy, and oh, a hurtling line.
White, scrum, red ball.
But it was a knock on from a USA hand, and Kenya get away with it.
Kevin Wakisa came on a dangerous line, but the pass was just a little bit too hard. And you note there, we mentioned Singapore 2016, Kenya lifting the gold medal. Great memories for them. I know many of them returned home and were given cars and all sorts of nice things.
Sit.
What did the Canadians get when they won?
Pat on the back. Well done, lads.
Driving across this play here.
Of course, the following year was Canada's big year. Nate Hirayama, who's here with HSBC and his team. Remarkable scenes for those Canadian boys. See what comes up next. A bit of a test in South Africa in the next match.
Well, it was against a lot of these men who are out on the field representing USA that they defeated in what was truly an epic final. Canada going 19-0 up, USA fighting back, and Canada with a late score to seal a famous victory. For Lau Nua,
closing the game, white
wants to get back to that final, but they have to overcome Kenya first.
Bush and Wally a little keen at the front of the lineup, close the gap. So USA with a good attacking opportunity.
Just scampering in those wide channels. High tackle coming in from the Kenyans. No yellow card though. Seven play seven. But USA with the momentum. Good low tackle. Halts them behind the game line. And then they win the breakdown battle. Holding on. Brilliant chop tackle.
Well, that's the physicality. The Kenyans are happy to play that way. Chopped and then did the work at the breakdown. They're off and running now.
Oh, another hurtling line coming in from Kevin Wagesa. Dropped onto the toe, and Kenya looking to turn the big men of USA, but well dealt with by Joe Schrader.
Player without the ball. He's running on his own line.
Schrader's won the penalty at the breakdown. He looked lumbering there, but big unit. He did well. Perhaps that kick should have been a little bit deeper.
Well, look at that.
Yeah, Schrader.
You're right to say he's lumbering. A little courtesy nudge in the lower back to say that he had company. But
white two.
The stat we just saw previously with the missed tackles.
I'll put white on the line.
From the USA. They won't be very
white
happy.
Five.
Down towards around about a 50%. Completion
Kenya
at the moment.
Line, your step on it, please.
There's Joe Schrader, 6 foot four, had a bit of a haircut, literally, since we last saw him on the series. That's loose.
That is loose, but gathered by USA. No. Foot to the floor, arm only going one direction, and that is to Tritown. Well, how a game can change in the turn of a gear stick. From first to top gear in a matter of seconds, Kayvon Williams burning through the heart of the Kenyan defense.
Well, I was gonna use a Route 66 or a Route 1 reference, because he picked it up and off he went. Simply backed himself, look, he's grimacing. But they know these players so well. They know they've got pace on certain men. And a fantastic line. And that's often when the opportunities occur, when the ball's momentarily spilled. The low conversion is added.
Time's too off.
Mike Friday will be happy.
Can I go?
As is the American contingent here in Singapore.
White nine white.
Few replacements.
Complete.
Bit of confusion. That's the captain. Sounds like going off. So they're going to miss the wheels of Nelson Oyu. That is a real high steepling kick and gives USA the opportunity to win it right back. Another try would really make things difficult for Kenya. Beautiful ball floated over the top. dogged defense from Kenya. They've got a shallow sweeper in there, so no kick option for the USA. Big man, Joe Schrader, who did all that busy defensive work chasing back before.
Entry.
Side entry, though.
Ball wide entry.
Yeah, and it was big. Kevin Wakisa, again, another penalty against him, coming in the side of the ruck. That allowed the Americans to slow the game down just over 2 minutes here in the half.
Well, penalty against Wakisa, but he has been good. He has been prominent. He's been physical.
And there's Kayvon Williams. Look at that. Series tries. He's right up there. Kennedy obviously leading, and Sefo, who started well this morning. But Kayvon knocking at the door as well.
Well, Ken didn't start bad either. He scored the try that was the final nail in the Fijian opening pool match coffin. A famous victory for Ireland over Fiji in their first match of their pool. Terry Kennedy wrapping things up with a late try to put it beyond doubt. Look at that fend. Ooh, big hits beginning to rain in from the white jerseyed Kenyans. Newer, the distributor. Kayvon Williams, the try scorer, picked off one-handed. It's a foot race. Oh, and he won't be caught. Kenya burn away for what must be the equalizing try.
Well, he took his chance, didn't he? He took the gamble in defense, stuck out the big left mitt, and it stuck. This conversion is crucial. Looks easy, but after 14 minutes of rugby, having not played in a few moons. Oh, no, it's low. It's under the bar.
Underneath the crossbar from right in front. Goodness me. It was Edmund Anya who had the sticky mitts in midfield to pick off the pass. He went the distance, but look at this. Oh my goodness.
Innocent Simiyu, that is a coach killer. You've done all the work. There's 30 seconds left. They do have one more chance to try and get their hands on this ball.
It's a big, high, hanging kick, and USA come away with it. All they need to do is tuck it up their jumper and ride out the closing moments on the clock. Some hesitation. Get it out is the call, and they do just that. USA squeak past Kenya, 12 points to 10. But will Kenya look back to rue that missed conversion? I think they might just.
Wow, great stuff. Sevens is back, baby. The USA maybe not in their best form, but doing just enough there. Kayvon Williams stepped up at the big moment. The captain was excellent in this match.
Well, for Lau Nua, the Salika. For Lau Nua, 2.0 was pulling the strings and doing a lot of good stuff out there. But as you said, it was that try through the heart of the Kenyan defense from Kayvon Williams, wearing six for the USA, that was the difference. Perry Baker got himself on the try line, but the shake of the head tells you he's not happy with the performance.
He's got a fast track here in Singapore. Let's see if he can make use of it. Gavin Diamore, Malachi, Esdale. It's a very potent team when they're firing.
Well, a hard-fought victory